Don't dare come to me. You better come to Mama. Trust me on that.
Oh, this is not good. Go that way. Unfortunately. She's gonna want to stop here. Don't allow it. Anticipatedly. Did she do that or did you? Don't allow that. He's coming back to me. Use your weight. Keep your leg long. Yes, that's good. Pick out a spot and stop. Don't use your reins. Stop. Perfect. Now turn to your right, using your weight, and pressing on your left leg if you need to. Call her attention. Stand your ground. Use your weight. She's backing up. You've got your legs too far back and up from the knee. Your lower leg is back. That's a sign to back up. Sit straight. Squeeze with both legs forward.
She's looking at me like, what the hell are you doing up here?
Go forward again. Come on. Squeeze forward. Yes. Now turn to your left. Using your weight and reinforcing it with your right leg on her shoulder. That's perfect. Yes. Again. Yes, ma'am. Good for you. Straighten her up. Don't let her come back this way. She's going to want to. Don't use your reins. Come on. Yes. Very nicely done. Now back to the right. Good. Give me another halt. Header. Go forward. Good for you. Circle, small circle to the left. Now. Good job. All the way around. All the way around. Come on. Force it. Good. Now back to the right. And down the long side. Good job. When you get to V, halt. It's on the wall. Header. Back up 4 steps. Nope. Stop again. Use your lower leg and lean back just a little. Up. Again. Nope. Just your lower leg. Sit very still. Nope. Try again. Whoop. One more. Tell her back. Whoop. That's the way, yes. Now, did you see what happened when you used your upper body as well? Now go forward. Squeeze from your waist down. Good. Circle to the right. Don't let her come any closer. All the way around. Circle. Good. And halt. Now, ever so slightly lean back and back up again. Just slightly behind the vertical with your upper body. That's right. There she tried. Did you feel her?
Yeah.
She rocked back and you gave up. Excuse me, too soon. Do it again. Lower legs. Easy. She's confusing that with go forward. Lean back. You're using too much pressure from your seat and your lower. There you go. That's right. That's right. There you go. Love on her. That was nicely done. Okay, that we need to work on. Now, pick up the wide rein and post your car. Give her as much freedom as you can and still guide her. Pick up your posting trot or a two-point. And let's see if she's going to blow anything out her nose before we get started. Looks good. Now sit your trot and halt. Not bad. Trot on. Good. Circle, don't let her come to me. Straight up, don't lean forward. Halt. Good job. Now this time, to the left. Trot on. Turn, use your weight, come on. Good, and halt. She's got steam up, don't use your rein. Come on, don't cheat. Halt. She thought she was coming home on that one.
Yeah.
You gotta watch her. Now back up again. Too much leg. Just move your legs back, but don't press on them.
Oh, back. Good girl.
Reward that. Now from that point, it's just going to simply be a matter of her understanding the difference between the way you do it and the way I do it. Okay? That was well done. Do you have any questions?
No.
Okay. Pick up your reins, and now we're going to talk about the difference between connection and collection. Connection simply means that you've got contact on the bit from your reins. And when she's collected, she's arching the back and picking your weight up and grounded and using her butt. I will be very, very happy if today all we get is a good connection, so that she's listening to you, okay? Pick up your rein. No, just the wide one. We're gonna work only on the snap. Okay? Now, I want you to squeeze on your rein very lightly and see what she does. Keep squeezing. Keep squeezing. There, see it? That's the posture that you need. That's almost perfect. Keep it now. And as you ask her to walk forward, your inside hand is the control. Your outside hand is your balance rein. So she's going to balance on your outside rein, which means it must never change. It has to be like a side rein, solid. And you signal her to flex at the jaw and bend in the neck, always with your inside rein, with little squeezes. Got it? Okay. And then, after she is in position, you signal from your waist down with a little shove forward with your seat palms. Okay? That's perfect. Yes. Bend your elbows ever so slightly and pick your hands up and close your fingers and make a fist. Balance on that outside rein. Squeeze on the inside rein to keep her flexed at the jaw and bent in the neck. She must always be bent and flexed in the direction of travel. Turn a big circle from fence to fence right there. Now she needs a little bit more connection. So shorten up your reins. When a horse walks, it bobs its head like a chicken does. We've talked about this before. So your elbows have to go forward when she bobs her head down so that it doesn't restrain her. That's better. Hold your fingers. Good. She's looking to the outside. That inside hand has to be very, very vigilant. The outside hand just balances. A little bit more on your inside rein. She's almost there. There. The second that she puts her head down like that, you reward her, however so slightly, and the operative word is slightly, moving your hands forward. Uh-huh. Again, flex to the inside. Don't let her look at me. Good. Inside, inside, inside. Now, tighten up your outside rein and anchor it. Flex to the inside. Good. Good. That's perfect. Shorten up your inside rein. Now, squeeze with both legs as you're squeezing your inside rein at the same time. And trot. Perfect. Look at that. Beautifully done. Now listen up, because I'm real don't you lean forward, sit your trot. Anchor your elbows, anchor your outside hand. Don't let it go forward. Good, good, good right there. Now, as I want you to give her the signal to halt, and then before she actually does, loosen up and let her walk. Do you understand me? Try it. Perfect. Perfect. Keep the bend. Never allow her to look to the outside, Lisa. You've got to watch that, because she'll cheat on you. Trust me. As often as she possibly can. I want you to do that again. Gather up your reins. Talk to her on your inside rein. Squeeze, 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 squeeze. Balance on that outside rein. Yes. Beautifully done. And again, when she goes down for you like that, soften. That doesn't mean loosen. It means only soften. Walk. Perfect. You've got to cue her just with the tiniest bit more gas when you ask for that transition to the walk, because she almost halted on you. Feel your way through that. How much is just exactly right. Again, pick up your trot. I'm up on your rein. Your inside rein is too long. Squeeze on it. Squeeze on it. Good. Right there. Perfect. Perfect. Good for you, Lisa. Now walk right away and trot right away. Don't change anything. Keep her bend and flexed. Her ears on me. Be careful over here. She's going to try and cheat. And trot on. Good. And walk right away. And trot again. Perfect. Perfect. Careful, don't let her out too much. And walk. Good. Now make a U-turn to the inside. We're going to go the other way. Turn, turn, bend, bend, bend. Remember that the rule is bend to the arc of the circle. The smaller you make your circle, the more bend she must have and the more flexion she must have at the jaw. Do you understand that? The size of the circle must match, or her bend must match the size of the circle. Okay, now you've got a new inside rein that you're going to be squeezing on to signal her changes in gait. Your outside rein balances her so that she stays in position. Shorten up both reins just a tiny little bit, and as you do, put a little bit of pressure on your legs so that she doesn't resist that. When you're ready, squeezing on your inside rein and with both legs on, pick up your jaw. Careful, that was almost too much gas. And walk. Good job. And trot. Keep the bend. Good for you. Good.